Hi, I'm Nicole, and I'm going to tell you a story about my unusual hobby. 1 year ago, our family flew to the ocean on vacation. I had been admiring it from the shore when suddenly my brother Dylan suggested,
"Do you want me to teach you how to swim?"
The boat was taking us further and further away from the shore. The waves darkened ominously. It was probably very deep where we were. I was shaking with fear. No, I don't think I want to. I've changed my mind. Let's go back to the shore. But then Dylan smiled slyly and pushed me into the water.
Swim! Work with your legs!
And with all my might, I flopped around. The waves were hitting me right in the face, and it was difficult for me to breathe. And that's when it hit me. I was drowning. Scared by my screaming, Dylan pulled me out of the water. Clearing my throat, I slapped him across the face. Have you gone mad? I could have drowned.
But that's the way my dad taught me as a child. I thought that you, feeling the danger, would swim.
For the rest of the vacation, I didn't go near my brother or the ocean. After it happened, I firmly decided I would never go near the water again. However, on the first day of school, I had to. Over the summer, a swimming pool had been built at the school, and now PE classes were held there. Just looking at the water made me feel dizzy. But my classmates were full of enthusiasm about it. My crush Melvin and my eternal rival Lucy swam to the finish line before everybody else. And there, she rushed to hug the love of my life.
Wow! We won!
I was contorted with anger and maybe a little bit of jealousy. What a tiresome girl! I didn't want to be worse than her in any way. So I walked to the edge of the pool, squeezed my eyes shut, and I jumped into the water. But I didn't feel the bottom under my feet, and my fear returned. I foolishly floundered, and I began to scream desperately. Through my tears, I saw Melvin. He jumped into the pool to pull me out of the water. Even when I was safe, I couldn't calm down. I was shaking all over and crying nonstop. The teacher had to call my parents, and they took me home.
Gosh, baby, we were so scared. Why did you get into the water again after that incident on vacation?
I thought I could do it in the pool.
I forbid you from swimming. Do I make myself clear? I'll talk to the head teacher, and you can be transferred to another group in PE.
All day, I prayed that my classmates would not recall my shame. But the next day, Lucy greeted me with a mockery.
You're almost like a mud duck, but you can't swim.
Then you must be an otter doing so well in the water.
Haha, you should know, I have a lot of talents in general.
Lucy handed me a glossy magazine, and there was a picture of her in a swimsuit on the cover. I put on my best poker face, and Lucy finally buzzed off. But I couldn't deceive myself. I was so terribly jealous. So, on the way home, I stopped at a newsstand and bought a magazine to get a better look at my rival. And there it was. Lucy was starring in an advertisement for a free diving club, and judging by the text, she was also in the club. So, I Googled it. Free diving turned out to be a deep dive without scuba gear. People just hold their breath and travel underwater. Ugh. Just the very thought of water gave me goosebumps. But my curiosity came to be stronger than my fear. I decided I would visit this club and find out exactly what my opponent was capable of. And an incredible sight was waiting for me there. Guys and girls were diving into huge glass pools wearing long flippers. And it was so fascinating watching their swimming that I didn't even notice Melvin was approaching.
Oh, Nicole, what are you doing here?
I have the same question for you.
Lucy and I have been practicing here for a long time.
Oh, Lucy and you.
That sounded disgusting. But then Lucy showed up with a satisfied grin.
Oh, the swimmer's here. Don't tell me you came to take a dip. I think I'd die laughing.
Yeah, don't worry.
I'm just looking.
Oh, no, of course. I mean, if I had a body like yours, I'd be shy to undress too.
Lucy spoke so loudly that everyone could hear her. The guys burst out laughing. Even Melvin got a smile on his face.
That's it! I've had enough! This thorn in my side was gonna pay for everything she had said.
I grabbed Lucy by the shoulders and I pushed her into the nearest pool. But she had a death grip on me, so we fell into the water together. Everything happened so fast that I didn't even have time to get scared. Reflexively, I just jerked my arms and legs, and somehow, I swam to the pool's side, all by myself. I would never have thought that it was so amazing to conquer a fear. I wanted to experience it again, and that evening, I went down to the pool in our courtyard. So, how did I do there? Hands off, feet up and down. The main thing is just be brave, hold your breath, and it worked! It worked! I was about to continue when suddenly my mother's voice rang from out the window.
Nicole, what are you doing?
Get out of there! Was it not enough for you the last time?
Mom, but I...
Stop arguing! Do you think I won't punish you seriously?
I had to obey, but I enjoyed swimming so much that I decided I wasn't gonna give up. At school, I found Melvin. I'm really embarrassed to have to ask you, but please train me in the pool after classes. In return, I can do your homework for you.
Yeah, fat chance. You can't swim at all. So what's gonna happen if you get water in your lungs? I'm not getting in trouble because of you.
I think I could be your coach.
I stared at Lucy in surprise. Why would she suddenly be so kind? But really, there wasn't time to think about it, so...
Agreed.
I regretted it at the very first lesson. Lucy just kept shouting at me, and in the end, she called me a clumsy hippo. But I had to hand it to her. These strange methods worked. I stopped being afraid of the water, and I even learned to swim in 3 different styles, and even diving. Still, though, I had to hide it from my parents. I lied to my mom and dad and told them that I was learning to play the piano after school. They got off my back, and I enjoyed my new hobby. But after about a month, I got bored of dragging myself around the pool. Lucy, I know how to do this. I want to swim underwater.
No, it's too soon. You're still too insecure in the water. You could never go that deep.
No way, I could totally do it.
You chose me as your coach, so listen.
I think I'll listen to Lucy when pigs fly. That same evening, I signed up for my first free diving class. Diving turned out to be not as scary as I thought. I spent 20 seconds underwater, and the coach even praised me. And Lucy had told me not to do it. She was probably just jealous.
6 months flew by. My life changed dramatically. I became a real freediving star. And when I beat experienced competitors at the competition, I was offered to advertise the club instead of Lucy because she had stopped coming to the club at all. My photos and the image of a mermaid flooded across the internet. Finally, I had smoked my eternal competitor, and Melvin became my boyfriend. But just one problem remained. My parents still didn't know anything about my success. Until one day, when I came home from training and I found guests there. Dad had invited his boss and his wife to visit us. I was about to sit down at the computer in my room when Dad suddenly said,
"Nicole, what great timing. Play us something fun."
Maybe another time? I'm really tired.
Oh, please, please. You've got to make our guests happy. I've told them so much about you.
Damn it. I sat down at the piano and I tried to remember the chopsticks that I had learned as a child. But I just couldn't remember a single damn note. If I had just gotten up and fallen on the keys, it probably would have turned out better than it did. The guests and my parents looked at each other disgusted. And Dylan choked on the cake he was eating with laughter. I hung my head in shame. Of course, my parents and I had a showdown that evening.
What was that?
Improvised. Nobody's playing the classics now.
Nicole, where do you really go after school? Just stop lying. It's clear that you're not doing any kind of music.
I go to the gaming club.
Everything's better. Just as long as it's not swimming. You had us so scared.
It seemed to me that my parents were believing that story. And the next day, with peace of mind, I came to a new shooting. I posed for a photographer in the depths when, suddenly, I saw my brother and my parents behind the glass. My mom ran up to the wall of the pool and started pounding on it with her fists. She was obviously frightened. But when I got out of the water, her face changed.
You, how could you?
Mom, please don't get mad. I can swim now and I'm not afraid of the water anymore.
You almost drowned, twice. And after that, you want me to let you wander around at the bottom of a pool? Take off that mess and come home now.
It turned out that Dylan had ratted me out. He had seen an advertisement for the club on social networks, and he'd showed it to my mom and dad. Immediately, they stopped working and came running after me. So as punishment, my parents put me under house arrest. I couldn't go to my favorite classes anymore. The only thing that saved me from depression was Melvin's support. But one day, Lucy told me something pretty awful.
I know we don't get along very well, but I still think I should tell you the truth. Last night, I saw your boyfriend kissing another girl.
No, you're lying. Melvin and I have a great relationship, and you're just mad that he didn't choose you.
Of course, I didn't believe Lucy, but she still completely managed to spoil my mood. I cheered up only after the summer holidays came. After all, I was going to a camp by the ocean with Melvin and all my other classmates for a month.
It would be freedom at last. As soon as we unloaded things from the bus, I immediately changed into a swimsuit and I rushed to go to the ocean.
Water, how I missed you.
I swam a decent distance from the shore, even further than when I'd been there with Dylan. The ocean just didn't scare me anymore. I enjoyed every move, and I didn't notice anyone around when suddenly a golden earring, Melvin's gift to me, disappeared beneath the waves. I decided I would dive for the earring, and at the same time, I'd show everybody my skills. But swimming underwater in the ocean turned out to be much more difficult than in the pool. The salt water stung my eyes painfully, and I got pushed back to the surface and carried off somewhere. I tried to swim, but the more I tried, the faster the shore receded. Help! Help me! With the last of my strength, I raised up my hands and I waved. I suddenly felt sleepy. Everything went dark. I realized that I was drowning. When I opened my eyes, I saw Lucy's frightened face above me. She was almost strangling me in her arms.
Thank God! You're alive!
What happened?
You started sinking! You're lucky that I was nearby and managed to get you out. You scared the hell out of me, Nicole! I told you it was too early for you to learn to dive. You have to learn how to properly swim first.
But why did this happen? I had been doing so good in the pool.
What's wrong with you? You're comparing a puddle to an ocean. The swimming technique out here is completely different. Besides, your sudden success has you acting like a chicken with its head cut off.
You're being rude.
It's just that I was the same. I started freediving for fun, but suddenly I started to succeed. I won competition after competition, and eventually I became the face of the club. You yourself should remember how I got all puffed up. I considered myself somehow special and invincible. And in the end, at one of the training sessions, I wanted to set a record and surprise everyone. I ignored my coach's command, and I stayed under much longer than I was supposed to. I don't remember what happened after that, but when I recovered, the doctors were screaming with joy. None of them believed I would live.
Wow, Lucy. So that's why you stopped showing up at the club and discouraged me from diving?
Yes. When Melvin turned you down, I felt sorry for you. But then you got so unbearably stubborn. In short, you just repeated my mistakes. It's scary to imagine how it could have ended if I hadn't been here. And, you know, I wasn't lying about your boyfriend. Go ahead, take a look.
I looked around and I saw Melvin feeding ice cream to some girl. I almost drowned and he didn't even come see how I was? God, am I stupid or something? I went to such extreme classes to start a relationship with a narcissistic peacock. I fell in love with the attention that I received because of my diving.
After what happened, I gave up on freediving, which made my parents incredibly happy. They, in turn, allowed me to do regular swimming, and Lucy and I started going to the pool together. That's how I lost my boyfriend. But I found a good friend who wasn't afraid to risk her life for me. Didn't take me very long to forget about Melvin. After all, Lucy and I met such handsome guys at the pool. It doesn't matter how cool they are. I'll never walk on the bottom for anyone. Go ahead and send this video to someone who definitely needs it.